इच्छति ईशावास्यमिदं सर्वं यत्किञ्च सत्यं जगत् तेन त्यक्तेन भुञ्जीता मा गृहस्थस्य स्वस्थनम् मूकं करोति वाचालं पङ्गुं लङ्घयते गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वन्दे परमानन्दमाधवम् ॐ प्रणो देवि सरस्वति वाजेभिर्वाजिनीवति नामवित्यवतु ॐ चोदयित्री सूनृतानां चेतन्ती सुमतीनां यज्ञं दधे सरस्वती ॐ असतो मा सत्समय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्योर्मा अमृतं गमय ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनस्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु सुखिन सन्तु सर्वे सन्तु निरामयाः सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखमाप्नुयात् ॐ शान्ति शान्ति
A very good morning to everyone present over here. Respected Vice Chancellor, Somaiya Vidya Vihar University, Dr. Raj Shekharan Pillai, Principal Dr. Suresh Ukrande, Vice Principal Dr. Sunita Patil, Coordinator ICAST 2021, Dr. Hariram Chavan, HODs, Deans, Faculties, Staff, and Authors of ICAST 21. I, Dr. Namrata Ansari, Coordinator of ICAST 2021, welcome you all to the 4th International Conference on Advances in Science and Technology 2021. KJ Somaiya Institute of Engineering and Information Technology Science, in association with University of Mumbai and the IIT, are pleased to organize the 4th ICAST 2021. I feel very proud to state that consistently our college has managed this international level conference every year. Obviously, it goes without saying that great efforts went in preparing for this day. ICAST has achieved its objective in providing an effective forum for academicians and researchers to advancing knowledge, research and technology in recent trends. While concluding, I take this opportunity to welcome each one of you. Enjoy your participation in ICAST 2021. Thank you. Have a wonderful conference day. Now, I welcome our Vice Principal, Dr. Sunita Patil.
Good morning. Respected Dr. Rajashekharan Pillai, Vice Chancellor, Somaiya Vidya Vihar University and Provost for Somaiya Educational Institutes. Our Principal, Dr. Suresh Ukrande, Coordinators for ICAST, Dr. Namrata Ansari and Dr. Hariram Chavan, heads of the department being track coordinators, deans of various sections, faculties, staff, students and dear ICAST participants being the authors of the papers and attendees for the conference. I, Dr. Sunita Patil, Vice Principal of KJ Somaiya Institute of Engineering and Information Technology, SIAN, Mumbai, welcome you all for the inauguration ceremony of 4th International Conference on Advances in Science and Technology organized in association with the University of Mumbai and the International Professional Body, the Institution of Engineering and Technology, the IET. Dear authors and participants, KJ Somaiya Institute of Engineering and Information Technology, SIAN Mumbai, is one of the top ranked engineering institute under University of Mumbai, and I am very glad to share with you that recently we have been granted with the autonomous status by University Grants Commission. At our institute, when we had applied for accreditation by national level regulatory bodies, that is National Assessment and Accreditation Council, NAAC, for the institute, and for our departments by National Board of Accreditation, NBA, we have received the accreditations by both the regulatory body, and we have found that we are lagging somewhat in the area of research development and consultancy activity. And that's how ICAST, we have decided to organize the international conference wherein our faculty and students can contribute for the research and development activity, and we could able to inculcate the research culture amongst our staff, students and faculty, and our students and faculty can get the chance to interact with the international level research community, the research authors, and the exchange of information and knowledge can be shared between the academic fraternity. And that's how in the year 2018 we have started with the first ICAST, and now we all are here in fourth ICAST, that is ICAST 2021. In today's ICAST, total 134 papers are going to be presented by national as well as international authors across total 10 panels. We have received a total 238 research papers across the globe, and we have conducted the rigorous review as well as the double check plagiarism process, and out of that total 134 papers are shortlisted for the presentation in ICAST and publication with the elsewhere's SSRN digital portal. As already said, at our institute, we identify all the areas where there is a scope for improvement, and we try our best to organize many more activities or the events to contribute to that area and provide the best platform, not only to our faculty and students, but everyone as a part of academic fraternity. So with this intention, we have started the membership of various professional bodies at our institute, which are national as well as international. We have initiated various clubs, cells, committees as per the interest area of the students, and regularly we conduct many more technical, non-technical activities and events contributing to the growth of the academic area as well as the institute and the nation at large. And due to our continuous involvement in such all-round activities, looking for the 360 growth of our students, we have been getting many more recognitions, and we have been awarded by many more national and international level bodies. Like besides NAAC and NBA accreditation, our institute has also been recognized in National Ranking Institutional Framework, that is NIRA, as well as the Atal Ranking for Innovation, that is ARIA Ranking. Similarly, Ministry of Innovation Cells, that is MIC's Institutional Innovation Council, and AICTE CII's Indopact Survey for the industry linked institutions. So these are a few of our major recognitions due to such kind of activities which we organize throughout the year, looking at the growth of our students. And besides this, our students regularly participate in all the national international level competitions and activities, and get the awards or the recognition like Smart India Hackathon, which is organized by AICTE, Touch the Jovian Moon Contest, which is organized by ISRO, Deep Blue competition, which is organized by MASTEC, and many more competitions which are organized by professional societies. So dear authors and dear participants, the kind of platform we are providing for exchange of information and interaction at international level we will try our best to continue the legacy in future also, and a similar kind of many more platforms will be available for you to participate and interact with each other in the academic fraternity. So thank you so much for participating in ICAST, and I wish all the success for presenting your papers in ICAST today after this inauguration ceremony. Now I would like to request our principal Dr. Suresh Ukrande, who is also associate dean for Faculty of Science and Technology at University of Mumbai, to guide with his words of wisdom. Sir, please.
Good morning to one and all. The Chief Guest of Conference, Dr. Rajasekharan Pillai, Provost Somaiya Vidyavihar Institutes and Vice Chancellor of Somaiya Vidyavihar University, Vice Principal Dr. Sunita Patil, Coordinators of the Conference, Dr. Namrata and Dr. Hari, HODs, Deans, Faculty, Staff, Students, Organizing Committee of ICAST 2021, and all the participants. I, Dr. Suresh Ukrande, Principal of the Institute, welcome you all on behalf of management, faculty, staff and students to this International Conference on Advances in Science and Technology, that is ICAST 2021. This is fourth year of conference and we received very good response in terms of quality of research papers. This conference has helped create great research culture in our institute and provided platform to researchers across globe to present their research work. If we look at statistics of publications and patents across globe, we lack in both. The number of publications in India is approximately 50,000 in a year, and that of USA is 6 lakhs and China 13 lakhs. These are the figures of 2019. The total contribution of patents of 5 countries, that is China, USA, Japan, Germany and South Korea, is 77%, and India's contribution is just 0.77%, which is less than 1%. The development of any country depends on the research, innovation and development of new technology. Hence, I feel we have to go a long way with strong determination. It is the responsibility of every individual faculty working in universities and institutions and scientists in research organizations to contribute to the great extent. Hence, we at our institute, as per the directives of management, identified agriculture and healthcare as major domains for research and contribute to the best of our capacity. Recently, we have received autonomous status from UGC for 10 years. There are only 2% of institutions having autonomy across India, and we are one of them. Hence, with strong academics, best culture of research and innovation, we will prove ourselves, our institute, as a role model autonomous institute few years down the line. I appreciate efforts taken by coordinators, HODs, deans, and organizing committee for the grand success of this conference, and congratulate to the researchers who are part of ICAST 2021. Thank you. Now I welcome Chief Guest of the conference, Dr. Rajasekharan Pillai, Provost of Somaiya Vidyavihar Institutes and Vice Chancellor of Somaiya Vidyavihar University, to address the August gathering. He was a former Vice Chairman and Chairman of UGC, Vice Chancellor of 3 universities earlier to this, and Executive Director of NAC. Over to Provost Sir. Thank you.
Dr. Suresh Ukrande, Dr. Sunita Patil, Dr. Hariram Chavan, and the members of the Organizing Committee of ICAST 2021, distinguished delegates and the attendees of this conference. I have great pleasure in welcoming you all for the International Conference on Advances in Science and Technology 2021, organized by the Somaiya Institute of Engineering and Information Technology under the Somaiya Vidyavihar. I appreciate the efforts taken by each and every one of you for the efficient conduct of this virtual conference with several parallel tracks representing a number of fields in science and technology. The transfer of knowledge, skills and solutions in the science and technology fields have a profound and lasting impact on the development of trajectories of nations and peoples. The world cannot develop or advance, nor can we achieve the sustainable development goals without modern technology and new solutions to old problems. The COVID-19 pandemic has underscored the pressing need for countries and their institutions to focus on elevating science, technology, and innovation, STI in brief, in both policy and practical terms. The pandemic also drives all of us in science and technology to ensure that the development benefits of science, technology, and innovation translate directly into daily lives of people across the nation. We need more research collaboration, data, and knowledge sharing to cope with the immediate impacts of the coronavirus crisis and go beyond it. More than ever, we need a multilateral approach to ensure that the science, technology, and innovation triangle serves both strategic and development ends. Computer science, information technology, artificial intelligence, and big data analytics play a great role in combating the coronavirus. Researchers and developers across the world are increasingly using artificial intelligence, machine learning, and natural language processing to track and contain the coronavirus, as well as gain a more comprehensive understanding of the disease. Between recognizing signs and symptoms, tracking the virus and its gradual genetic changes, and monitoring the availability of hospital resources, researchers are dealing with enormous amounts of information, too much for humans to comprehend and analyze on their own. It is definite potential solution that is seemingly tailor-made for the advanced analytics technologies. Researchers in information science, information management, and in information technology, like you all, have a great role to play positively in this field. Over the past few months, we have seen how digital technology helps in the fight against COVID-19 coronavirus. Expanding digital services can help alleviate the effect of COVID-19 on the economy. Digitalized economies have lower epidemic risks. Using cross-sectional data on internet usage and epidemic risk, it has been shown that countries with wider internet access and safer internet servers tend to be more resilient to epidemics such as coronavirus. Countries with wider internet access, effective net servers, tend to have better infrastructure such as energy and transport, stronger governance and human developments. These include health, nutrition and human development to cope with the pandemic. From a cursory look at the titles of the various talks and papers in this conference, I see that several such research interventions are also being reported in the conference. I am sure that the deliberations of this conference will be of great value in tackling developmental problems, particularly in a situation like this. It is very important that educational institutions of this kind promote research, particularly quality research, in a very significant way. I am also glad to note that the papers which are being presented in this conference are getting published in reputed journals published by renowned publishing agencies in the world. I congratulate each and every one of you for the successful conduct of this very important conference, which has been happening for the last several years in the K.J. Somaiya Institute of Engineering and Information Technology under the Somaiya Vidya Vikar. I wish the conference all success.
Greetings to one and all. On this wonderful morning, I, Dr. Hari Dhawan, would like to present the vote of thanks. The last few days have been very fascinating and engaging for ICAST 2021. Therefore, I would like to thank each one of you, because it is not just the coordinator, but the great support team who made this conference successful. First of all, I would like to thank Dr. V. N. Rajshekharan Pillai, Provost, Somaiya Vidyavihar, Vice Chancellor of Somaiya Vidyavihar University, Mumbai, for sparing valuable time and giving some meaningful insights. Sir, every word counts for us, and we tend to improvise based on your valuable suggestions. My heartfelt thanks goes to Principal Dr. Suresh Ukrande, sir, who has been a constant source of inspiration and, more importantly, for bestowing trust on me and Dr. Namrata for such a huge responsibility. I would like to thank Vice Principal Dr. Sunita Patil ma'am for guiding and suggesting the correct way to proceed with every stage of the conference. Let me thank Dr. Namrata, Dean Academics and Coordinator of ICAST 2021, for being exceptionally cooperative and ever ready for any work. My big thanks to all the head of the departments, deans of various sections, the complete technical team, panel coordinators, panel assistants of ICAST 2021. Let me also thank the conference team members, Dr. C.V. Sharma, Pallavi ma'am, Aarti ma'am, Bhagyashree ma'am, Meenal ma'am, Monika ma'am, and Rupali ma'am for working patiently to keep up with all tracks of ICAST 2021. And an obvious thank goes to the establishment section, especially the accounts team, for a great support. A special mention of Nitin Urankar sir, Kiran Hande sir. Also a special mention and thanks to Gauri ma'am, as she worked tirelessly to complete the task of plagiarism check. Thanks to the entire support team who helped us directly or indirectly with ICAST 2021. Before concluding, I would like to thank all research authors for being part of ICAST 2021 with a beautiful quote. Research is to see what everybody else has seen and to think what nobody else has thought. Now I will request all panel coordinators to once again explain all the guidelines regarding presentations with all authors and participants, and start with the ICAST presentations. Thanks, and wish you all good luck.